The Commission on Elections finally resolves the infighting within the ruling party PDP Laban. A special COMELEC division has ruled. The faction, led by Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi, is the legitimate PDP Laban, rejecting the bid of the other group, led by Senators Aquilino Coco Pimentel and Manny Pacquiao. Based on the resolution, the basis for the decision is President Rodrigo Duterte's chairmanship. The Cusi wing has endorsed the presidential bid of Bongbong Marcos despite the party's anti-martial law roots. Senator Coco Pimentel vowing to appeal COMELEC's decision on the PDP-Laban rift. He points out the decision is not immediately executory and they will ask the poll body to explain why they referred Cusi's petition to a division without informing their party. He also called the petition fatally defective. Pimentel adds only legitimate PDP Laban members should be allowed to resolve the issue. Pimentel is the son and namesake of former Senate President Aquilino Nene Pimentel, who co-founded PDP Laban with late Senator Benigno Aquino Jr. The cab of presidential candidate Bongbong Marcos downplays concerns raised by foreign journalists who are covering the son of the late dictator. His spokesman, Attorney Vic Rodriguez, opposed claims Marcos does not lend himself to media interviews. That's after his team refused to grant accreditation to members of the Foreign Correspondents Association of the Philippines. He says they have granted countless interviews. Marcos, though, has repeatedly dodged questions about his father's brutal and corrupt regime.
If he is not available, we made statements or I made myself available. So walang katotohanan yon. And for the FOCAP and for the BBC guy, ang obligasyon ho namin ay sa sambayan ng Pilipino. Kaya kami ay patuloy na nakikipag-ugnayan sa mga Pilipino, sa sambayan ng Pilipino, hindi ho sa banyaga o foreign media. We have made many countless interviews, both sa regional stations at dito sa Manila. But let me just be clear, let's not discriminate small media, regional medias, before you call. Some people refer to themselves as mainstream media. Anong tawag nila pala sa DZRH, sa SMNI, at yung mga regional medias? Hindi ba? Hindi mainstream? That is discrimination.
Rodriguez also brushing off concerns about Marcos supporters who are attacking journalists online. He says their main focus now is to end the campaign period on a high note.
Unity is our message. Our platform, nariyan po yan sa vlogs, sa commercial ni Bongbong Marcos, nandyan po yan sa mga speeches niya. Ang bilin ni presidential frontrunner Bongbong Marcos, if he could tone down on the political speeches, at magpapasalamat na lang tayo sa tao. Dahil nga sinamahan tayo, hindi tayo iniwan, hindi nagpatinag sa mga pangbubuli sa social media ng mga kapitbahay.
The camp of Vice President Lenny Robredo, meanwhile, files a complaint against tabloids over a report linking her to communist leader Joma Sison. Among those charged were the owners, publisher, and employees of journalnews.com.ph, People's Journal, and People's Journal Tonight. Robredo's spokesperson earlier denied the allegation, calling it fake news. Facebook urged to take down a network of so-called online trolls spreading disinformation in relation to the upcoming elections. That call coming from a group of Filipino-Americans called the U.S. Filipinos for Good Governance, which recently launched the website trollexposer.com. So far, the group claims to have found about 100 trolls promoting the presidential bid of Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Meanwhile, more than 700 accounts are sharing red-tagging content targeting Marcos's rival Vice President Lenny Robredo. The group says Facebook has not taken action despite their repeated requests. A disinformation researcher from the University of Massachusetts, meanwhile, suggests a better strategy to eliminate trolls.
Paminsan, if we focus too much on, you know, low-level accounts, it sometimes takes away from our focus on the trolls at the top of the hierarchy. And I call them the chief architects of disinformation. Troll hunting must always start at the top and hold accountable the PR strategists, political consultants who are running the show. Or else, hindi tayo mauubusan ng mga fake accounts.
An Australian freelance journalist is also expressing disappointment over Bombo Marcos's refusal to engage with international media. Aaron Cook asserts, as a Philippine presidential candidate, Marcos needs to assure foreign investors, diplomats, and other entities the horrors of his father's rule will not be repeated.
They need to be able to tell us why we're not going to be seeing some of the human rights abuses we saw in the 80s, why martial law won't be coming back, what he would be doing about corruption. There's still cases, cases into plundering and corruption that haven't been resolved. And I don't think the Marcos campaign has any interest in explaining to the rest of the world why that is and why he deserves to lead the country.
The Philippine National Police vows to provide additional security in areas placed under the control of the Pol body. As of May 4, there are at least 24 towns and 4 cities that are under COMELEC control. But the PNP notes the number of election-related incidents in the run-up to the May 9 polls is lower compared to previous elections.
If we compare the 14 validated election-related incidents as of May 4, this is way below the recorded validated election incidents in 2016, which recorded 133 validated election-related incidents, whereas in 2019, we recorded 60 validated election incidents. So we are hoping that the 14 recorded validated election incidents as of May 4 will not increase. Majority of the incidents are only minor incidents comprising of grave threats, light threats, and some physical injuries.
The Philippine Defense Department earlier said it is not seeing major security threats that may disrupt next week's elections. The country's power grid operator says the president's move to declare May 9 a special non-working holiday will go a long way in ensuring sufficient electricity on Election Day. But the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines still urges authorities to prepare for possible unplanned maintenance shutdowns, which may cause brownouts.
Closing down businesses and commercial establishments and industries do have a significant effect on them, on demand. And at this late time in the day, when you're seeing thin supplies, then demand-side mitigation measures are the only way to go. Take, for example, on a Wednesday, which is traditionally the highest consumption in a week, April 27 Wednesday, your demand was 11,363 megawatts. Compare it to May 3, which was a holiday, you have a 1,000 megawatt difference at 10,326.